My dear friends in Jesus Christ, today we begin a great journey, a Lenten journey. In this journey, we tell God that we would like to get back to Him. And we are telling God that we need Him. We acknowledge our sinfulness and we recognize our need for God. And we begin this journey today on this Ash Wednesday. My dear friends, every Ash Wednesday tells us that we have a God who forgives. We have a God who like to have us back. We have a God who can save us. As we begin this journey of Lent, I tell God that I need to get back to you, Lord, for probably I have gone too far. And therefore, I'm ready to take a penance today. I'm ready to do something differently during this season of Lent. And I do today, take up the ashes, put it on my forehead in the sign of the cross, the symbol of a cross, and tell the whole world that only Jesus Christ, who died on the cross, can save me. And I tell the whole world that I belong to Jesus Christ. My dear friends, the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 10, verses 32 would tell us, if you acknowledge me before the people, I will acknowledge you before the God the Father. And that acknowledgement is done in a very, very special way in this season of Lent. Today, in the scripture, Prophet Joel tells us the Lord is going to come. His day is approaching. And therefore, we need to prepare ourselves to receive the Lord, to get into His company completely, and He should see us worthy of having Him. And first of all, this Ash Wednesday is telling us that we have a God who saves us. He doesn't look into our sins. He looks into our desire to get back to Him. My dear friends, few years ago, when I was in the missions, a young man came to me and said, "Father, I have messed up with my life. I know God cannot forgive me. God will not forgive me. I have done things, so much things, in such a way that God cannot look mercifully upon me." And I sat with this young person, and the Holy Spirit, you know, helped both of us to go a little deeper into the mercy of God. And finally, we came to the realization that however great is our sin, our God is a merciful God. He cannot abandon His children. If we have the desire to come back, the Lord will welcome back, and He is our Savior. Again, in the Acts of the Apostles, we see that there is no other name given to us for our salvation but the name of Jesus Christ. And therefore, my dear friends, today we cling on to that name that saves us, cling on to that name that heals us, cling on to that name that delivers us. Let's begin this Lenten season with the confidence that we have a God who saves us. Secondly, the Lenten season is telling us, especially the Ash Wednesday, is inviting us to the fact that God gives us a second chance. And we know that there are books written about God giving us second chances. And that is the experience of thousands of people. God knows that you and me are weak. God knows that you and me are frail. God knows that you and me are human beings, prone to commit mistakes, sin. And therefore, God is out there to give us another chance. That's why God spoke in the book of Isaiah, chapter 1, verse 18. He said, come back to me. Let us sort things out. This journey is a journey of sorting out things with God. Come back to me. Let us sort things out. Even if your sins are like scarlet, they will be made as white as snow. Your life, your soul will be made as white as snow. And therefore, the God is reassuring us in this journey, the journey of Lent, that we have a God who washes all our sins away. And even if it is great as the scarlet, and God will wash it clean and make it pure. And thirdly, we can obtain this salvation only through a change of heart. This Lenten season is a time God gives us to look into our hearts and see where I need to change. A change of heart is a must to obtain the salvation the Lord is giving us. In the book of Joshua, chapter 3, verse 5, we see God is telling us to sanctify yourself today, and tomorrow the Lord will work wonders in your life. Sanctify yourself today. Tomorrow the Lord is out there to work wonders in our lives. And the condition is this, that God should find us with a heart that is sanctified, that is purified. Only then God can intervene in our lives as He wants to intervene. My dear friends, today in the Gospel, St. Matthew is asking us not to parade our good deeds. Change of heart also would mean this, not parading our good deeds before other people. As human beings, normally we may have the tendency to show off what we do. We naturally could have the tendency of having other people recognizing us, and then slowly in all that we do, looking for recognition from other people. We also may have a tendency to see that other people glorify us when we do something differently. Saint Matthew is telling us we have already received our reward if we do things in order to make other people feel good. If we do things in order to make other people acknowledge us. And therefore, St. Matthew is very clear, and he says, do not show off your good deeds, but do things secretly. All that you do, do things secretly, because God looks beyond appearances. God sees deep down in our hearts, and therefore He wants to see things done in humility, things done only for Him. And there He will find a true change of heart. My dear friends, as we begin the journey of Lent, let's ask the Lord to give us the grace to understand that God is a God who forgives our sins, who can take us back, who washes all our sins away. And secondly, the God also is a God who gives us a second chance. Do not worry about the past. God looks at the future. He always gives us another chance to get back to Him. And thirdly, God wants us to give ourselves completely as a person who is purified, sanctified, and with a heart that is willing to change. Let's invite our Blessed Mother Mary to be with us during this journey, and it is she who can take us to her son, Jesus, in a way that he wants us to get back to him. God bless you all. Enjoy your London journey.